spree. It's very clear to see that a spoonful of sugar helps the medicine go down.
The dessert stomach. It's a part of our bodies that isn't included on any models or in any textbooks or indeed in any body, but I am pretty certain that it exists. Otherwise, how could you explain how I can always have space for a dessert? It can't be because I'm greedy, so it must be something else. It's actually all down to a phenomenon, or maybe I should say phenomenon nom nom nom, called sensory specific satiety. Satiety is actually a word that I literally said out loud for the first time about 30 seconds ago, so I hope I'm pronouncing it right because I have been burnt before with words like carousal and chored. But anyway, here's an explanation of why we feel like we have a dessert stomach. Sensory-specific satiety, the reason you always have room for dessert. Sensory-specific satiety is a phrase that was first coined by Barbara and Edmund Rolls, who obviously felt like they had to dedicate their lives to studying human response to eating because they're named after a form of bread. It's the name given to the fact that we can eat one food to the point of feeling full, but then mysteriously stop feeling full when we're presented with something new. In other words, it's saying that a key part of feeling full is just being bored of what you're eating. Then when something new comes along, we feel like we can squeeze it in as the pleasing anticipation of something fresh and exciting overrides our feeling full signals. The Rolls pair are just two of many scientists who've done legit studies investigating sensory-specific satiety. Studies like this one, which refer to your mouth as your oral cavity. And if you think that's too formal, then you can shut your damn oral cavity. But here's one experiment you could actually do at home if you wanted to prove to yourself that sensory-specific satiety is a real thing. You will need two flavours of milkshake, and that's pretty much it. I've gone for banana and chocolate, but choose what you like. You might also want a friend to do this experiment on, but I don't have one of those, so here I am. This experiment needs to be carried out over a couple of days. On the first day, this is what you do. Drink 300 millilitres.
Cheers.
Of one flavour of milkshake as fast as possible. Then pour out 700 millilitres of the same flavour.
700? This is excessive.
Drink as much or as little as you like, but measure how much you do drink. That's it for day one. Then on a different day.
Different day. Jazzy a jumper.
Do the first step again.
Cheers. I feel like you don't want to watch this.
300 millilitres of that one flavour in one go. Pour out 700 millilitres of the other flavour and drink as much or as little as you like again. Again, measure how much you drink.
That's science right there, my friends. Science in action. Boom.
What you'll find is that you always end up drinking more if a new flavour is presented to you, as long as you like the new flavour. This is a clear example of sensory-specific satiety in action and the reason why we always have room for dessert. We're anticipating how the taste of the dessert will differ from what we've already had and therefore convincing ourselves that we've got room for it in our bellies. And this doesn't just work with taste. Apparently, colour, shape and texture all can have this effect too. Sick of yellow Smarties? Then why don't you move on to red? Tired of pasta spirals? Hey, give tubes a go. Sensory-specific satiety has your back. But why have we developed it? Well, I guess it makes sense really, right? If we eat a wide variety of foods, then that's a way to make sure that we've got a varied diet, and so we're more likely to take in all the nutrients we need to stay healthy. Of course, the issue here is that this sensory-specific satiety mechanism evolved many, many years ago, and our dietary situation has changed a lot since then. Many of us now live in a time of plenty, with lots of different types of food readily available. And not only do we often have many different flavours within one meal, but we have things that we can add to foods to make them less dull, like ketchup for chips or ice creams for brownies. Ice creams, many ice creams for many brownies. Not that brownies are dull on their own, in my personal opinion. So being able to constantly put new tastes into our oral cavities means that we end up eating to excess. And so sensory-specific satiety, which originally was meant to help us eat healthily, ends up leading to unhealthy eating habits. A key example of where this is an issue is all-you-can-eat buffets. And back in 1984, a study showed that you're gonna eat 44% more food if you're given four plates of different food compared with four plates of the same food. That's a lot of fours, but the point is, you'll eat a lot more. Sugary foods are a particular issue because it's been shown that sugar actually relaxes the stomach and so makes you feel like you're less full than you actually are. And this is another reason why we always feel like we have room for dessert in particular. We feel full, but then because of sensory-specific satiety, the thought of something different is appealing. So we eat a little bit of dessert even if our stomach is full to bursting. The sugar in the dessert then relaxes our stomach, convincing us that we have even more space to squeeze in the rest of the brownie. Of course, when this relaxation wears off, your stomach reconstricts, leaving you with that super bloated feeling that I'm sure lots of us can relate to. It's a situation that certainly strikes a chord with me. The finding that sugar relaxes your stomach was discussed in this article, which yes, is in Norwegian. Fun fact, dessertmage is Norwegian for dessert stomach. You find out something new every day. Before this video, I thought that said dessert mage and assumed it was just someone you had to fight in the PlayStation game Yu-Gi-Oh! Forbidden Memories. Am I right? No, it's just me that knows that reference, fine. Also, something else I learnt the other day, because I was watching a history programme, broad spectrum of interest, I know, is that apparently in Victorian times, they used to put mustard in their inner ears because they thought that that would numb the nerve that made them feel full, and then in feasts, they could eat as much as they like. Huh, try that at home. Don't do that. But let me know how it goes when you don't do that. So there we go, seems like we're psychologically predisposed to overeating. But what about a trick that could stop us from doing so? Well, let's think of it this way, right? If your sensory-specific satiety kicks in sooner, then that means you're going to feel full earlier and so eat less food. Then you might actually have space for dessert. Having smaller portions to start with can help with this, but turns out so can eating in smaller bites. If you have smaller mouthfuls, even though the amount of food you're eating is reduced, the number of mouthfuls you're taking in is still the same. And so your brain becomes bored of the food just as quickly, even though you're taking in less. So your sensory-specific satiety kicks in sooner, you get bored of the food quicker, you eat less, bish bash bosh. Legit room for dessert. This effect of taking in smaller portions was actually studied using orange soda, so I assume they didn't use Kel as a participant because we all know.
Kel loves orange soda!
So there we go, turns out sugar relaxes your stomach, but also we can't help but pine for something new and exciting. Now you're aware of the tricks your body uses to try and convince you you've got space for dessert, you can battle against them. Or just don't, like, you know, whatever you fancy. Good stuff. Thank you so much for watching. Jazzy. Tweet me if you want, comment if you like, subscribe if you fancy, but whatever you do, remember to have a lovely day and keep asking questions. Here's the sweet, sweet summary. Let it relax your stomach with its sweetness. Nice one, so relevant. This is entertaining, isn't it? Okay, I actually need to check how you say this word. Satiety.
Satiety.
Satiety. Do I have to say it like that? Satiety. Nice, pungent. Pungent stuff. They're named after a form of bread. It's the phrase given to me. I can't laugh that much in my own joke. Bread. No bread laughs, thank you. Here we go again, pronunciation.
Dessertmage.
Dessertmage. Tell you what, there is always space for tea.